Abhishek, and I am doing my BTech from BGSBU in Electrical and Renewable Energy. Today I will show you about how to get a sine wave on a cathode ray oscilloscope using a function generator. In this experiment we use a function generator, a cathode ray oscilloscope and a knob, a patch coil. Function generator in which is a device in which we can produce different type of signals, triangular signals, rectangular signals, sine wave signals. It is by the help of function generator, it is very easy to calculate. We can adjust the frequency at different levels and also amplitude. There are three buttons: frequency, amplitude and function. And we can, by pressing the frequency, we can adjust the frequency of a wave. By adjusting the amplitude, we can adjust the amplitude. And by function of function, we can function. For example, there is sine wave, we can press it. There is another triangular wave, there is square wave, and there is ramp wave. We will simply take the sine wave, there is sine wave. This is the cathode ray oscilloscope, and we have connected the knob to the channel 2. So we have to take the channel 2 voltage in consideration. So to calculate the amplitude, we have to take the peak to peak, how many divisions are acquired by the wave. So see, there are two divisions. So we have to multiply the two divisions into the channel 2 voltage, that is 10. So by multiplying this, we get the peak to peak amplitude. So in order to calculate the frequency, first we have to get the time period of the sine wave. To get the time period, we have to see 1 second, how much division the 1 second is completed. So we can see here that the 1 second is completed in two divisions. So we have to multiply the 2 microseconds into the two divisions. How many divisions are taken? That will be 4. So in order to calculate the frequency, we have to, f is equal to 1 by t. So we have to divide the time period by 1. So we will get the frequency. Thank you, sir. That's all. Subscribe our channel.